हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू यज्ञा इन्वेस्टमेंट एकेडमी। टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट सोवरेन गोल्ड बॉन्ड्स इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इन जून 2015। SGBs, एज द नेम सजेस्ट, आर गवर्नमेंट बैक्ड सिक्योरिटीज विच आर लिंक्ड टू प्राइस ऑफ गोल्ड। द प्राइमरी ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट टू इंट्रोड्यूस दिस SGB स्कीम इज टू रिड्यूस इम्पोर्ट ऑफ द प्रेशियस मेटल, विच विल इन टर्न हेल्प इन रिड्यूसिंग आवर ट्रेड डेफिसिट as well as our current account deficit. How? We are one of the largest gold consumer in the world and we consume almost 1,000 tons of gold every year. Most of it is imported. And gold is the second largest expense on our imports after oil, which was almost $35 billion last year. Now let's discuss about the key features of this scheme. First is eligibility. Only Indian citizens can invest in this scheme and not NRIs. Eligible investors can include individuals, HUFs, trusts, universities and charitable institutions. The normal bonds issued by RBI are issued at the face value of rupees 100 or 1000. But gold bonds are different. Gold bonds are issued at fixed gold weights. So 1 unit of gold bond is basically a 1 gram of gold. So the investor need to buy minimum 1 gram of gold to subscribe to the scheme, and maximum he can buy is 500 gram per fiscal year. The bonds are available in these denominations. Next feature, interest, is the most attractive part of this SGB scheme. Rather than owning gold in physical form or an ETF and not earning anything on it, SGBs mean owning gold and also earning interest on it. The government has fixed interest rate of 2.75% per annum on the amount of initial investment, but remember, there is no compounding of the interest and it will be paid to your bank account every half yearly. Explaining it by an example, suppose you buy a 10 gram of gold at rupees 30,000 and after 1 year the price increased to 32,000 rupees. Then it means you gained rupees 2000, which is almost 6.66% return. Now suppose you buy a 10 gram of sovereign gold bonds at rupees 30,000 and the price increased to 32,000, then you also get an interest of rupees 2.75% extra in that case, which makes your return to 6.66 plus 2.75, which is 9.4%. This makes the interest a very attractive proposition for SGBs. SGBs can be bought in DMAT as well as paper form. The redemption price of the SGB is based on the price of gold of 999 purity, which is published by IBGA at their website ibgarates.com. SGBs are not available all year round. They are issued by the RBI at the interval of almost 3 months. And each subscription period, which is almost of 1 week, is called a tranche. Till now, 5 tranches has been released in November, January, March, July and September 2016. And next is expected around Diwali 2016. Tenure of the bond is kept at 8 years, but the premature redemption of bond is permitted after 5th year. If you are concerned about this lock-in period of minimum 5 years, worry not. The government has given the option of tradability of the gold bond as well. So you can buy and sell these bonds on NSE and BSE index as well. Government is using many channels to sell the gold bond. The purpose is to make gold bond more easily available than physical gold. So you can buy the gold bonds from majority of the commercial banks, both online as well as offline. And designated post office and even BSE and NSE are acting as a receiving offices. Incentivize these distribution channels. The government is giving 1% of the total subscription fees as a commission. Another big advantage of SGB is tax benefits. There is no TDS deducted on the capital gain. If we sell the SGB before 3 years on stock exchange, then we may have to give the short-term capital gain tax, which will be added to our total income tax slab. But if we sell after 3 years, we get the long-term capital gain tax as in physical gold, and which will be 20% with indexation. major advantage come if we hold the SGB till the maturity. Then there is no capital gain tax on SGB. But do remember, the interest which you get on SGB, that is 2.75% per annum, is fully taxable based on your tax slab, and it is irrespective when you redeem this SGB. As we have discussed, returns in SGB are market linked and they will depend obviously on the gold prices prevalent on maturity after 8 years. And SGB, which means owning gold and also earning interest on it. The other features to note are that the gold bond can be extended for 3 years more after the maturity. Joint holding is allowed, nomination facility is also available. And the best part is that you can use it as a collateral for taking loans as well. Now, after understanding the key features of SGB, the important question arises: should we buy SGBs or not? If you are a type of investor who considers gold as a necessary investment, or who is planning to buy gold coins or gold bars in near future, or who buy gold only for pure investment, then yes, gold bond is made for you. It has all the qualities of a good gold investment. You will get the same return plus interest with a peace of mind. We will discuss the detailed comparison of SGBs with gold ETF, gold funds, as well as physical gold. Till then, if you have any question, please do write in the comment section below. Have a great time ahead. Thank you.